Duck Dynasty has been one of the most successful reality shows in TV history. Now the family behind the phenomenon is launching out with a new project. The Duck Commander musical is kicking off in Las Vegas. And joining us now with more are Willie and Corey Robertson. Welcome, guys.
How you doing?
Hi there.
When most people think about rednecks, musicals aren't the first thing that comes to mind. How did this idea for a musical come about?
Well, we actually wrote a book called The Duck Commander Family right after Duck Dynasty came about. And the our agent in New York, that's a theater agent, came to us and said, I think your family story has what it takes to become a musical. And once we got over our shock and Willie realized that he wasn't actually going to have to be up there singing and dancing, he actually thought that at first. But once he got over that, we, you know, thought about it, and she said, you know, it's a story of American dream. It's a family that stuck together through good times and bad. It's a story of a family that has relied on their faith to get them through really difficult times. And here we are in Vegas with a musical.
That's wonderful. Well, tell us about the story and the songs. How much of a role did you have in creating the musical?
Well, we had a lot to do with it. We've been working on this, like Corey said, for 2 years. We've been sitting down with the writers back when it was just an idea, and then we heard our first couple of songs, and then we thought, well, this is starting to sound pretty good. It's actually good, and the stories have meaning and heart. You know, I think this musical has heart, and you'll see this played out, and they're fun too. It's kind of like the show in a way where it's fun. I mean, it's funny, and you'll have those moments, but then there's also these deep, heavy moments. I mean, going all the way back to Phil and Kay's life and their marriage, whenever, you know, there was these, you know, forks in the road, and they could have went a different way, and none of this would have been here today. And so we had a lot of involvement with it, and the direction, especially the tone and how it went.
How much coaching did you give the actors to help them portray you guys as you really are?
A little bit. I think it's really about them just coming to be with us. We invited them to Louisiana, and they spent a weekend with us eating crawfish and frog legs and just hanging out with our families. And we could tell they were kind of studying us, trying to see, catch our mannerisms and see how we say certain things. And, you know, we've just gotten to be a big family. We love all the actors. We love the crew, the producers, the director, the set designer. It's just been an incredible experience.
Let's talk about Uncle Cy a little bit. He's a scene stealer at times in your TV show. What about the play?
Well, leave it to Uncle Cy to steal the show again, and he certainly does that in this one. He's got some really funny lines that he has, and the guy that's playing him is just he's quirky himself, and so he reminds me a lot of Cy. And so there's a, you know, kind of when the show came out, the television show came out, it kind of, there was this weird phenomenon that went on that a lot of ladies like Cy, and they would send him marriage proposals. And Cy's been married for 40 years, and so for some reason they thought he was single because they didn't see his wife on the show. So he starts getting all this stuff, and we deal with that in the musical. And he has a song called Ladies Man that, let's just say it ends very Saturday Night Feverish, and it's pretty funny. You just got to see it.
Well, I know your family's Christian faith is a big part of your lives. Talk about how it's portrayed in the musical.
Well, it is a big part of our lives. It is, you know, the most important things in our lives. And so in everything we do, from the TV show to our books to the musical, we want that to be first and foremost. And so the very first song is called Faith, Food, and Family. And it starts out, you know, talking about what's important to our family. And you see it all the way through within the decisions we make and when we go to God in prayer throughout all of it. It's not, the musical is not preachy at all. It's not, you know, trying to really teach anybody anything necessarily. It's just kind of showing our lives and how we live them, and hopefully we give glory and honor to God in all that we do and the decisions we make and the way we live our lives and the way we try to shine our light. And I think that comes through in the musical.
Showing who you really are and what Jesus means to you. Well, what's something the audience may be surprised to learn about the Robertsons?
Well, I think probably the thing that they'll be surprised at is that we actually dealt with some of the controversial things that have happened since our television show came out. Some things that Phil said, you know, we dealt with them right there on the stage. And, you know, the musical is put together by a lot of different people and people from all different walks of life. And so we just dealt with it right there. And we said, hey, let's just go ahead and put it in there. It tells this story. It's very dramatic. And that's when the family gets tested. And really, you're looking at it, and it could all go away tomorrow. And so we were kind of at that another fork in the road that that we had to figure out which way. And we said, hey, we're sticking with God. And it's worked out.
All right. Willie and Corey Robertson of Duck Dynasty, thank you so much for your time, and we really appreciate your witness. We said a prayer for you guys before the interview. Thanks again.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.